Well, this gets the award for the most neglected dog at the show. Oh my word. Admittedly, the guy who brought it to me said it's sat forever. The pick guard plastic has disintegrated. It's all cracked and falling apart, cracked here. I'm going to have to take this off because the controls are all frozen in time. I think I've got a pick guard. I don't think I can put this back on. These screws have been replaced with something, not the right ones, but we're not there yet. These all look frozen in time, so this is after going to get soaked. That is just wicked. I got to get condoms on. We got a lot of corrosion on the pickup poles. Oh, goodness. But hey, before we waste a minute, everyone should know by now, what do we got to do? Let's make sure the truss rod works. I got to put hand condoms on, though.
Well, let's see what happens. I found it. We're going to loosen it first. Well, it turns. So we should be okay. The neck looks relatively straight as I eyeball it. Everything's got to come off. And like I said, I don't think this pick guard's going to survive the removal. That's like totally disintegrated. Yeah, somebody's messing with my head. They've got Robertson screws. Do I have that little guy? This guy here? No, it's even smaller than that guy. What are you doing to me here, folks? And she be loaded with springs. So, the easiest way to deal with this is I'm going to remove the whole trem block. I'm just going to put the whole thing right in the ultrasonic cleaner. And clean all the schmutz off it. What am I looking for? One of these. Yep. Come on now. There we go. Yeah, and to be honest, we didn't even plug it in to see what kind of noises it made. I'm scared. That ain't bad. Not as bad as I thought it was going to be. Okay. I was told it had issues. Noisy. But this is bad. Gotta take this out. I really don't want to reuse these screws. They're freaking welded into the guitar. If I really, 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 really had to reuse these screws, you know, like if I was on a desert island or something. Well, I sort of am. I live in Canada. Except there's no desert. Oh, come on now. Yeah, if I really had to, I'd soak these in some oil for a while. Yeah, try and clean them out the best I can. That one doesn't even want to return. Just wondering why the mismatched pickup screws. That could be interesting. It tells me I'm not the first human in here. I guess the pick guard was probably swapped. Got them all. Oh, I got a knob come off for me. Oh, this is bad, 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 bad. Oh, and it's, oh, I got the one that didn't want to come out. What do we do? What do we do? How do we do it, David? What do you do? How do you do that? What do you do? We got to get something underneath here to lift it up so you can get it out. Does it still seem stuck? Oh, there we go. Ooh. Yeah, and they didn't really leave me enough wire to turn it over and look. There we go. Warmouth guards. Warmouth plastic is shiter. Look at that. It's just disintegrated. The only thing holding it together is the sticker that says Warmouth on it. We got some rubber grommets under. And what are these? Van Zandt. So the pickups have been changed at one point in time. What on earth did they do here? It's, there we go. Yeah, I think I'd really like to swap that pick guard out. And I do believe I have one in white. This is just junk. It's not going to get any better. And I wonder if I have the right screws for that. You can even see what the shitty plastic did to the finish. Right? Yeah. Oh, and these guys, the little, it's all had to come apart anyway, because all the little rubbery guys that adjust the pickup height, they're all like frozen. Look, let's just throw that in the garbage right now. I don't even want those around. It looks like big snot balls. So the easiest way to deal with the crud on the neck is I'm going to take the neck off. I should have maybe done that before I released the pick guard, but we'll be okay. We'll just keep this stuff from jumping around with a little bit of masking tape. Everything's going to be fine. I just wanted to get rid of that pick guard because I really didn't want to touch it. Look. Good enough. Let's get the neck off and clean up these frets. They're not dented or anything. They're just corroded. Well, I found all replacement screws for all the pickups and for the switch. Oh, I know what I need. A bunch of those little rubbery surgical tube things. Well, it's looking pretty good now. Let's see if we can make it Stratocast. We're going with 10s. And we already got a block in the back. We just want this to go one direction.
No setup for you, mister. I get to the end of my travels here. And thinking everything's a-okay, the bridge pickup is down. I'll demonstrate. So I'm bypassing the switch that controls everything. That's the bridge pickup, which that's all it does. Then we'll go to the next pickup. That's what we'd want to hear. Then we go over to the next one, and once again, that's what we want to hear. Van Zandt, these look like good pickups. It's a shame. So I'm just going to carefully put it aside, and I let the guy I know that owns it, that he's down a pickup, and we'll figure out what we can get for it, and swap that out, and then we can make it Stratocast. I'm going to sign off, guys. All the links to cool things that could help a guy, an old guy like me out, are below. Thanks to all my patrons, everybody who grabbed a sticker or a CD. Special shout out to my Facebook group people, everybody on Twitter, everybody out there, thanks so much. Okay, we're just going to set this guy aside. What did I do here? Did I wreck it? What did I do here? Oh, the strings have fallen down into the block. There we go. There. Just leave that like that for now, won't we? Cheers, folks. Be good to each other.
Well, let's see if we can sort out a Stratocaster, which was here. And everything seems to measure out pretty good. I'm just going to go through it and show you what's going on.
Okay, so right now, neck relief is good. That's 12 thou, guys. So it's like if it's sloppy, well, then we're at 14. If it's too tight, we're at 10. You can, but it's a feeler gauge, right? So that's, we're not touching that. It's absolutely good. The string action, I did have a quick look at this. Now, I'm just going to point out to somebody who's trying to use one of these fancy little tiny measuring sticks that has tiny little markings on it. You want to be able to see the line
So when I'm measuring 4/64 at the 17th fret, I want to be able to see the line. The line should not be vanished. So right now, the string action is set broaching too low. Just not very much, but a little bit too low. It's got the tilt function, but I'm not going to screw with it. I'm just going to show you what's going on. I will reset the string action in a minute and see if this goes away. So what we got is choke, choke. So, it's possible we have a high fret, but I'm going to correct the string action just ever so slightly, just a bit, just a little bit, and see if it goes away. Let's see what happens. The other thing to remember, too, is that if you're playing with a lot of effects or distortion or overdrive or reverb or whatever you're using, a lot of that, I just pointed out, will probably not be noticeable. But as soon as you try to clean up the tone and hear nice ringing sharp notes, well, you heard what you heard. But like I said, the string action has been set a little bit too low. You probably never even noticed this playing wise, but it might just solve that. And then I'll check for high frets. All right, then. What happened? Turn this up. That's fine. Yeah, baby, I'm not going any farther. Just double check this. But that's what it was. I mean, you can... The other thing, too, is... This is why, I mean, as much as I don't like Stumac, I always use this measuring stick. I've got about half a dozen over here. And depending on how, somebody likes me. Depending on how well they've made this, also depends on your ability to actually use it properly. So like I said, the line should not disappear. You should be able to see, just see the line below the string to the top of the fret. And that's your measure. Set it aside. I'll check it again. But that was all it was. One of those tiny little lines on there. Too little. Too less. Just a hair. Let's retune it. Anyway, guys, girls, folks, there you go. One. That's one down. I'm not even going to cut the camera. I'm just going to fix another Stratocaster. I'm going to keep going. I can't remember, excuse me, if I signed off on this adventure from the other day, but after doing a huge cleanup and trying to make the guitar work again, we realized that it was down a pickup. So we have a brand new DiMarzio. What is this thing called? Frick if I know. It is a super distortion. Woo! All right, so let's pop the neck, and I have not
tied that back down since I did the troubleshooting. So, a little bit of soldering, and then I can set it up. Just having a close look at this dead pickup, because sometimes you can bring them back, but I'll get a little more light going here. But I see the issue. I don't know if the camera's picking it up. See all that green? Corrosion, oxidization. So what's happened is the lacquer insulation has probably been gooched. And so now the coil has found its way to short itself out because that corrosion has eaten through the insulation on the lacquer. Just fool around with this for a minute. So when I put the ohmmeter on it, I get a reading, 35 mega ohms. That's way too much. But if I'd hit the beeper, right, there's no continuity through the coil at all. So, yeah, baby, that's a piece of garbage. So, and also just a tiny bit of insight as to what, why would that happen? That's what happens when your guitar is ridden hard and put away wet. And, you know, or it could have been some beer splatter or something. Something got in there that allowed that to happen. I'm hoping the camera's getting that. All that green shit on there. I got my favorite block of wood in the back. It's just sort of, you know, not tuned up, just sort of tensioned up. Now we'll tune it to pitch, and I'm going to just crank a few of the strings to hold my block in place. That should be sufficient. Now we'll tune it up for real. Okay. Excuse me again. What's going on? Oh, I broke out in hives. That was interesting. Never had that happen to me in my life. No explanation. Luckily, I have probably the best medical doctor team that you could ever ask for. It's all brand new. It's all digital. It's all high tech. Right? There's somebody there all the time. I was able to get a video appointment on a Sunday afternoon. Believe it or not. Not with my actual doctor, but with someone who was there. So this is really, really close. I think I can just fix that with the tilt function. What are you doing, Dave? I'm going to move this by a very tiny amount. Probably that much. Like I said, it's so very, very close. Notice that I only slightly loosened the back screws. Check the tuning again. Seems pretty close. Sounds close. Sounds okay. Did we remedy that? Not quite. A little bit more. Just for the record, the same hex key that you use for the truss rod adjustment is the same hex key that moves this. Like I said, ever so slightly. How do we do? You got lights in your eyes and shit? Yeah, a few of them need a couple of individual adjustments because they're not all consistent, but that's very, very close. Let's get it all right and then we'll continue. Wow, that DiMarzio pickup is hot. I haven't set pickup height yet, but that rocks. Right, speaking of which, let's set the pickup height. That guy, too close, too close. That one comes up.
Wow.
Let's do intonation. That That pickup sounds really good. Nice. Good old intonation for every nation. Check, make sure they all work. I believe we're good. What's left? Oh, get that silly block of wood out of the back. Not a lot to see here, guys. I like to count the turns. Do a little checky check. We're miles away. I think we got it. That's it. She dropped. Where's the bar? Which is not the bar, but it's the bar I have to test it with. A little tight there, possibly. Right. Once the block falls out, you can still fool around with it a little bit. That's nice. Sweet. That's pretty much it. Everybody's asking me about this lube. Magic Lube. It's from Canada. I got it. They have it sitting on a counter at the 12 Fret Pro Shop. Walton Enterprises, Toronto. I think it's a bicycle thing that's just sort of been adopted, right? But the oilers are nice because I saved the other little one that I had and I put 3-in-1 oil in it. Actually, this is the one with the 3-in-1 oil, which I'm not going to use right now. What did I do with the lid there? Lid head? Oh, there it is. Yeah, so I mean, this one is the stuff. I don't know. Sort of looks like brake fluid. But it really does stay put. And, it really does make a difference. Okay. Oh, I'm under the string tree there. Retune this in a minute. Wipe off any little extra. Wipe off any little extra. I think our heat wave might be open. Oh, I gotta do something. I'm not gonna do it now. I gotta do it. Videos just came to mind. It's too late because I'm saying goodbye, right? That time where I say in the description below me there's things that you could participate in that would help me out. I think everybody knows what they are by now. Special shout out to all my patrons. Please jump in, become one. I will be here for you. Facebook group subscribers, Twitter peoples. Who's left? moms, dads, kids, goats, chimpanzees, and all the humans. Be good to each other. Cheers, folks. Ha 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 ha!